in a shocking turn of events, to absolutely no one. A scathing rejection of the last Bitcoin ETF proposal in 2019, the SEC said Bitwise failed to prove that the Bitcoin market is not manipulated. I already talked at length about how this was going to happen recently. I think they're going to cite reasons of an immature market and or manipulatability of Bitcoin as a reason why they have to protect US investors from the evils of Bitcoin. Not completely unjustified criticisms, but completely unjustified criticisms. So I don't want to spend too much time on it other than to say that this is a total double standard from the SEC. But if you put it from their point of view, it's a good angle to take. The hilarious thing about this is that the gold market, which is tremendously larger than the cryptocurrency one, is also manipulated. JP Morgan traders charged by the Department of Justice accused of rigging metal markets. So how is anyone ever meant to prove that cryptocurrency, a far smaller market, as not being manipulatable? The answer is, you can't. It's impossible. The SEC knows this, and they can continue to use this statement to reject anything positive for Bitcoin in the future. I think when they actually managed to find a few minutes to come on down to review this application, it took them all of 5 seconds to take a dump on it. Sorry. And in stark contrast, of course, the CME Group getting approval to inflate Bitcoin, on paper at least, nearly 2 years ago at this point. Okay. Pretty crystal clear to see an agenda here. And in a double whammy for US citizens this week, the Internal Revenue Service has issued its first cryptocurrency tax guidance in 5 years. Many people were, of course, looking forward to some further guidance. There were plenty of things which were up in the air, so this was needed. Now that it's here, well, be careful what you wish for. As you can imagine, some people are less than happy with the result. One of the few problems with it is their guidance surrounding forks, meaning any coin you potentially didn't even know you received, which, like most forks, tends to tank in value, might still see you get a big bill from the IRS, as a fork of an existing blockchain should be treated as an ordinary income equal to the fair market value of the new cryptocurrency when it is received. Okay, now there are some egregious examples of this. I'm going to use a few, but no doubt others exist. I'm sure many of you have heard of this. Bitcoin Gold, the world-changing technology, the original Satoshi's original vision. Now, there's the charts, not uncommon for a fork. What did it start trading at? What would the IRS consider its fair market value? Because if I look at this chart, it looks like it started at $480 and it's currently $8. Let's see, Bitcoin Diamond, another world-changing technology. Lovely chart. Started out life trading at $72. Or roundabouts. It's now 52 cents. So to pay this tax bill, which would probably be sizable, I'd have to sell all this coin, producing another taxable event in the process, then sell a part of my other crypto holdings because there's no way that selling all of this is going to pay for the original tax bill, creating another taxable event. I mean, damn, call me crazy, but it feels like the US has an agenda against crypto or something. In a disappointment to crypto users who like to spend their coins on everyday purchases like cups of coffee, the IRS specifically said it would not create an exemption for transactions below a certain threshold. Basically, this ruling could mean that you have to be vigilant against anyone forking or airdropping onto a token which you hold, because you might immediately need to dump it to avoid a big tax bill. They have to better define what fair market value refers to and over what period of time. I'm presuming, however, there is a silver lining to this. If your cryptocurrency went through a hard fork, but you did not receive any new cryptocurrency, whether through an airdrop, a distribution of cryptocurrency to multiple taxpayers' distributed ledger addresses, or some other kind of transfer, you don't have taxable income. So, I'm assuming then, if you never claimed any of the fork tokens, you could truthfully argue that, as they say, you did not receive any new cryptocurrency, then you won't be liable. But obviously, consult a professional. I am not one. Potentially, the IRS could turn right around and say, nope, it's not our fault you didn't claim it. That's your address. You've been holding for such and such amount of time. Those forked coins belong to you. Pay us some money. They have to better define what they mean by receive. It's very easy to get a different interpretation about what they're saying here.
Горбатая гора.
But anyway, lastly, let's take a look at what Bitcoin's up to. Seeing how Bitcoin yesterday broke out of the narrow trading range it was in, I think it's appropriate now to have a look at the 3-day charts to get an overall better idea of what's happening. I'll walk you through my thought process. In attempting to plot the direction of Bitcoin, I will draw some straight lines that will connect the lower highs up here, then down here, attempt to connect the lower lows. What this reveals is a clear descending channel, or otherwise, downward movement on Bitcoin. This setup would be invalidated, however, if Bitcoin can get up and over this descending resistance line priced in at around 9,700, but more importantly, get up and over the resurgence of the Vegeta memes in the process, which are, again, coming. Don't worry, I'll use one.